everyone. It's Tracy at Temperance Tarot, and this is a request video. This is specially for Gail from the Love of Cards group. Recently, yesterday, I got my hands on a Rider Tarot Deluxe, which is a U.S. Games release that was released. I'm finding contradictory information. Some sources say that the deck was released in about 89, some say about 96. It was probably in that range when I actually put the ISBN number that's on this box into my LIBIB app. It put the date as 96. So at any rate, it was a limited edition deluxe tarot deck that US Games put out in either the late 80s or the early 90s. And I managed to get my hands on one for a fairly reasonable price. Now the box is pretty beaten up, but it comes with a little sleeve, and the sleeve is nice and firm, so it's gonna protect the deck well. And then it also comes with an inner box that opens like that. This is the English edition. And then it slides out like this, and you have the little white book and the cards. And the cards are still in their cellophane, and you can tell that this is a pretty bad printing job. Look how far off the borders are on the backs. But I knew that. I'd seen the backs when I bought it. So we're going to take off the cellophane now and have a look. Now, I might get pinged for this, but here we go. Okay, enough of the music. Maybe I kept it under the amount of time to where I'll get pinged for that. But now the cellophane is off of the deck, and you can see it's gilded. There's an extra card in the back and an extra blank card. Cardstock is nice. You know, it's US Games, it's nice. It's that late 80s cardstock. The finish is not as matte as my 70s decks, but it's nice. It does have the copyright. And let's see, where's the Fool? Let's see where the Fool is. Oh, they're a little tiny bit stuck together by the gilding here. Got a couple of them, but they popped right apart. Oh, and it was just that. Oh, look, the backs are much better here. So the one that was bad was this one, these two, which are the extra cards. So hey, that's kind of nice. All the rest of them seem to be just fine and evenly centered. World, and is the Fool back there? Yes, there's the Fool. So there we have the Fool. I'm not going to show this deck, obviously, but oh, I'm very pleased. This is a very nice deck. It feels very good in your hand and has just a really, I don't know, something about that gilding gives it a finished feel that I'm really enjoying. Having to pop apart a few, but this was an unopened deck from sometime in the 90s. It's at least 20 years it's been sitting there in that cellophane. Borders are a little off there, so it doesn't look like they cut them as well, which also makes the borders a little off on the back, but I am certainly not going to complain about that. That's lovely. I am a Rider-Waite Smith girl, and I do collect Rider-Waite decks. I have half a dozen different yellow box Rider-Waite decks from different periods. I have, you know, two that are Samuel Weiser decks, and yeah, they did get a little clumsy with the cutting. But if you've ever seen the University Books deck, yeah, that got pretty really clumsy with the cutting. It's as it got towards the end, they got very clumsy. The University Books deck is really the worst cut deck I've ever seen. So let's shuffle it. That's really nice cardstock. I can see why they considered that deluxe. So there you go, very quick little uncellophaning of my Vintage Rider Tarot Deluxe. Thank you for watching this, and have a fabulous day.